Hi guys, I'll be joining the MBA executive program, that is the 1 year residential MBA program at IIM Calcutta starting 2021. And I have done my engineering in civil from Nirma Institute of Technology in Gujarat. And after that, I worked for a state sector PSU, which was Gujarat State Fertilizers and Chemicals, for around 8.75 years. And I used to be in the project management side in that company. And as of now, yeah, I'm just waiting for my classes to start. Let's hope so. Yeah.
All right.
So I already had my GMAT score. I gave GMAT in 2018. I had the score ready. And when in 2020, I decided to apply at various colleges. So as per my past experience, I had realized that working and simultaneously applying at various colleges, this whole process, it seemed very difficult and time consuming. And therefore, I decided to actually go with an admissions consultant. That was Goal ISV. The second problem was that we as people were used to having consultants or basically coaching classes face to face. And when in April or May, I decided to pursue with the applications, no format or no coaching center was ready to host us directly as a consultant. And with intensive Google research and feedback from various blogs, I stumbled upon with you, ma'am. And I'm great I did that. So, yeah, but the best part was that I think, ma'am, at your end, everything was very seamless and you were already prepared for dealing with the situation and this whole application process, even during the COVID times. So, yeah, it was difficult because I did not have a work from home policy because I was at site executing projects. So going to the office in the dire COVID scenario and then coming back home and then working on the application was definitely difficult. But I would say it was smooth and streamlined. That is why I was able to do it.
Right. So given the application process, there are so many steps to it, right? You have to collect your stories. You have to decide which ones to use. And then the recommendations, connecting with your recommenders. And you know, getting the application form in place, the SOP, the essays. So, how do you prioritize? What do you suggest?
So, there is one common advice that is given on every, blog that you would read is that start early. And I did not heed on to that advice, but I would definitely first thing that I would suggest is start as early as possible. Secondly, I think the most difficult part was, figuring out the stories. First, figuring out the stories because I had been working for 8 years and hadn't been in touch with, you know, writing all those things and collecting them from your past. So I think the introspection part is definitely the most difficult, the rewarding, and the most important part of the application process. So I think the candidates should, once they have the GMAT score, I would say, they should start with the introspection process as early as possible because the more time we give to it, the better stories come out of it. And as you had suggested, ma'am, that let's have all the stories and then at the later time, we'll figure out ki kaun si use karni hai and which are not to be used. So first is introspection. Second, I would definitely say that connecting with your managers in your current company, or if you're planning on giving a reference from any past recruiters or companies, so definitely connecting with them, because in the current scenario, as we are unable to meet them face to face, it takes a lot of time. So second would be that. And I think third would be finalizing a list of colleges and their requirements and accordingly then start acting on them.
Placements, how did you select your schools?
Yeah, so I decided to apply in only three colleges. That was ISB Hyderabad, I am Bangalore, and I am Calcutta. And for me, deciding the colleges, I think one was location was very important. That is why I decided not to apply at IIM Ahmedabad. Secondly, when it comes to ROI and the main selection of the colleges or the priority list of selection of colleges, I think ROI should come at second or third. The first two important points should be what is the cohort or the batch you are looking at. Because every college that is giving the 1 year residential program for executives, so the batch and the cohort and the diversity of experiences it brings is more important if you have worked for more than 5 years. Okay, so I think that should be the first one, because there are some colleges which favor IT crowd, there are some colleges which are having a balance, and then ISB is there which has people with work ex from 2 years to almost 20 years. So I think with my profile, the best suited colleges were IIM Bangalore and IIM Calcutta, because both had work ex, average work ex of around 8 to 9 years, and I was in the same bracket. And they provided, the batch were small in size, and there were more cohesive bonding or peer-to-peer learning that could happen in a small cohort as compared to the large cohorts. So that was there. And when ROI comes into picture, almost all these colleges, ISB and ABC, they have similar ROI. Almost ISB, if you give the ratio to it, it would be less. But more or less, they have similar ROIs. Definitely, ABC and ISB both are good brands and good brand names. So I think prioritizing the batch and how your particular profile fits with the college and that particular profile that you're looking after MBA or post MBA, whether those companies are coming for recruitment and offering those roles. So these things should come first, then probably the brand, and then the last should be ROI. Because having had a lot of discussions with you, ma'am, and the people who have passed out from these colleges, the ROI is not just your salary after 1 year or 2 years. It's basically a 10-15 year return you are looking at. So you cannot denote a number to it.
Right. So you were shortlisted at almost all the schools that you have applied to. Interview experience like?
The first interview I had was with ISB. On various things. Most of the questions were HR related. HR related, I mean the profile related questions. There were no technical questions. And I won't say that my interview were leadership skills that you are trying to bring to the table or add to the batch, and how those leadership skills and the qualities that you have as a manager, they have to be expressed and supported by real life examples. Bangalore interviews was quite short. They asked me about my work ex and then some of the co-curricular activities that I had mentioned on my profile. There was a discussion about it. For IIM Calcutta, the interview was again for around 20 to 25 minutes, I guess. And they started with the normal introduction and work experience. And then they went on to discuss various global scenarios or current scenarios in the world that are happening around India and nearby countries. And then they moved on to some of the extracurricular activities or hobbies that I had.
In terms of the uncertainty, which is, still prevailing, and it is, in fact, growing right now. So going for a deferral versus opting for continuing with the program or joining the program in the current scenario, how did you take the decision? What were the things that you thought about? And what are the things that mattered in that case?
So back in 2020, when I was applying, and there was already a batch who were getting their classes conducted online at home. So the first thing that comes into picture when we decide to do an MBA is the peer-to-peer learning. And the peer-to-peer learning, I believe, can only happen if there is a classroom-based discussion. It gets difficult on Zoom meetings and all. However, guessing the scenario that is as of now, this situation is going to remain here for at least 3 to 5 years. And as we had believed in 2020, there won't be such a grim situation in 2021. And so that was not true. Also, I did not decide to defer because I studied the pattern of MBA programs in 2008, in 2000, when there were global catastrophic scenarios or meltdowns or whatever. So the people who graduated in those difficult times actually had very good jobs 1 or 2 years down the line post MBA, because that is when the economy starts growing and there is a lot of requirement. So studying the market and the job requirements as of now, I decided that this is the best time to actually do an MBA, invest that time, and so that when this situation is over, you are one notch higher or one notch, you have another set of skills that are above the market. So that is the reason I decided to go ahead for 2021 program. And as of now, and as of how it looks as of now, that probably some of the program will be conducted online. But the later part of the program, I believe that we'll be able to go to the campus and have the required classroom discussions that are needed. So, yeah, I think even with the COVID situation, we should go ahead. And if someone wants to go ahead with the MBA decision and get into a good college.